The program for the week of May 15th to the 19th, 2023 is designed to present ministry officials and health managers with a robust agenda that includes cardiovascular risk management training for St. Lucia's healthcare staff, improving clinical management in the context of COVID-19 through HEART's implementation, and developing a monitoring framework for non-communicable diseases for improved monitoring and evaluation. St. Lucia's Health Minister Moses Jean-Baptiste says the workshop is timely as St. Lucia continues to struggle with getting its problem of diabetes and hypertension under control.
We know that we have a very serious problem, not only in St. Lucia but in the Caribbean. 83% of people who sadly pass away in St. Lucia pass away because of some complication arising out of non-communicable diseases, diabetes, hypertension, you know, that kind of thing. And so we are very concerned as a Caribbean region, especially coming out of COVID-19, coming out of the COVID-19 pandemic. We realized that a number of individuals who needed to get treatment at the health and wellness centers, they could not go for the treatment. Some of them could go, but they were afraid of catching the virus. And so a number of individuals stayed away from treatment, not only because at times they could not go because of isolation and that kind of thing during the height of the lockdown, sorry, of the pandemic, but also because we had supply chain issues. A number of our medications, we couldn't, even now we have shortages because of supply chain issues arising out of the COVID-19 pandemic.
HEART is a global initiative, and here in the Caribbean, which has very high hypertension rates, it is led by the Ministries of Health with the technical cooperation of the Pan American Health Organization, which seeks to integrate the initiative into existing health delivery services. HEART promotes the adoption of global best practices in the prevention and control of cardiovascular diseases. It also aims to facilitate better control of high blood pressure and promote secondary prevention with an emphasis on primary healthcare. St. Lucia's health minister says a change in mindset is required if St. Lucia and the rest of the region are to adopt the best practices associated with managing NCDs and cardiovascular issues.
We are hoping that this is not just an abstract exercise in technical discussions and doctors and nurses and so on, looking at technical discussions. Our hope is that we are going to take these discussions to the level of the community, the level of the family, that every family has a plan and every family focuses on know your numbers, what's your weight, and are you walking enough, are you drinking? So while this, we've always spoken about these things, but we put in a specific program in place so that at the end of a few years, the families will take charge. The doctors will not be begging you to come and check your pressure. We are hoping that will be routine in every family, because we are in a crisis where that is concerned.
A packed schedule awaits the 55 participants, including HEART and surveillance focal points from the Ministries of Health, as well as PAHO facilitators and resource persons.
It will be from today until Friday. So today and tomorrow we'll be focusing specifically on hypertension, and then on Thursday we'll be recognizing the World Hypertension Day through a regional webinar, region as in the Americas. And on Friday we'll be looking at NCD surveillance, because you need to be able to know the numbers of persons in each country that has hypertension and diabetes, and therefore be able to plan initiatives to deal with those issues.
The objectives of the workshop are to improve knowledge and demonstrate cardiovascular risk management, best practices shared for improved implementation in the Caribbean to an application plan for the hypertension control drivers, and an NCD monitoring framework developed to suit each country's situation. For the DBS News World, Jason Arius reporting.